Hey, welcome back to my channel. I hope you're having a great day. In this video, what we're going to be covering are how custom fields work and can be used inside of Highlevel and how they can benefit you. Before we get started, if you have not subscribed to my channel, please click the subscribe button on here, help brother out, as well as if you are interested in purchasing Highlevel, go ahead and click on my affiliate link. I do get credit for that. Thank you in advance, and let's get to it. So here we are inside of a demo account. And what we're going to be doing is looking at, first of all, defining what a custom field is and then how we can utilize that inside of the Highlevel system. So a custom field is basically a way of adding additional fields to a contact record that doesn't already exist inside of Highlevel. So let's take a look at this real quick. I'm going to take a look just at the contacts to show you what I mean. So I've just created a couple fake contacts here, and I'm going to open up John Smith. I'm going to pick on John today. So if you notice all of these fields, first name, last name, email, these are all fields you would expect to find inside of a CRM system. Date of birth, source, lead type. Now notice that they've got a couple of other areas here. General info that has information under it, like business name, street address, things like that. Time zone, and then additional information, there's nothing in here. Now, the reason why I wanted to point these out are these are going to be two additional areas that you can add custom fields to just as a way of organizing your the additional data that you want to put in there. For instance, do you want the data to appear at the contact level, or do you want the data to the new field you're adding to be included in the general info area or the additional info area? Notice that the general info and additional info are not viewed by default. You have to expand it. So there may be fields that you want at the base contact record to be seen by default and others that are important, but you don't necessarily want to cloud up the main screen. You want to hide those under one of these additional areas. So additional info is really great area that you can add those to. And when we create a new contact, a custom field, I'm going to show you how we can choose what area it goes in. But just notice some of the other things that we have here. These are some of the fields. Now, to get to custom fields, you're going to go to the, once you're in the sub account level, you're going to go to the settings and come over here to custom fields. Now notice that we already have certain custom fields here. Notice first name, notice where it's at, the contact. So that's at the contact level. I'm going to scroll down here, business name. Notice this is general info. Remember that little tag that we had to expand that says general info that has business name, business address? Great. So now you're kind of seeing these folders. How do you organize the custom fields into what particular folder? Now, let's utilize this as an example here. Just think, in your particular business, you may have certain other data regarding your contacts that you may want to record that Highlevel just doesn't have a current field for. That's why Highlevel created custom fields, because they want you to create as many fields as possible to populate as much data as your business wants to contain on a contact. That only makes sense. That's what makes Highlevel CRM systems so powerful, because it's extensible and you can expand it to whatever your business needs are. So right now what I'm going to do is I'm going to hop back up in here. Now, if you don't know, I'm a military veteran. I know if you're a veteran out there, thank you for your service. Right now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a military veteran status field, and it's just going to be yes or no. This is a way of keeping track to see if somebody is just a veteran, and it's just another piece of information that you may potentially have about your contact. So right now, there's a couple of different ways that we can do this. We want to choose, use some of the options down here. We could use a radio select button. We could use a drop-down list. I like drop-down lists. They're a little bit more cleaner for me, so I'm going to pick a drop-down list. And I'm going to click Next. Now, here, depending upon what type, I skipped over this, but depending upon what type of data you want to collect, you may want a single line, like a single box text. You may need additional information. So this multi-line is literally you could type multiple lines of text in at once if you want to keep track of like a just multiple lines of data. You have text boxes, number values, phones, monetary. You know, if you're looking at a certain dollar amount that you want to select, other fields that you can select from in here. But right now, I'm going to select the drop-down list and go to Next. Now, I'm going to call this military, if I could spell, military veteran. Now, the object is going to be the contact record. This just means there's no other There's no other object inside of Highlevel that you can assign a custom value to other than a contact record. So I know this sounds crazy. Highlevel may at some future event allow you to do something different, but right now the contact is what you want to select here. The group is going to be important because the group is where you select where you want that field to be inside of the contact record. Do you want it at the contact level? The general info level, where you have to expand that and show the general info where the business data was, like business name, or the additional info area. Now, for this one, I want to put this one just at the contact level. So it's going to show at the main level of contact without having to expand the additional, with these other fields, the general info, the additional info fields. And we're going to see that. So here we're going to select that. This is where we get to type in our options. It's a drop-down list, so what options do we want to have? I'm just going to select yes, click add an option, or no. That's it, very simple. Yes or no, that's the only thing you can pick in the drop-down list. You can choose this additional preferences, but right now there's no need to rename specific key values. That's a little bit too geeky, but just leave it the default. A high level will assign it one. And now we're going to click save. So great, now we've created a new field. We've taken the database that's inside of the CRM system and we've increased the number of fields that a contact record can have so they can contain more data. So this right here is perfect. So now we're going to go back to the contacts area and we're going to just select John Smith again. Now notice when we scroll down with John, notice that we've got this nice little military veteran field here. This wasn't here before. So now we've selected this and we can simply choose this and simply select yes or no if John is a veteran from here. So this right here is just an example of how you can include any number of fields that you want and have them show up inside of the contact system. Now, that's great, but I want to sit back and even go a little bit further. Because now that you know how to create a custom field for any particular data you want to store, you can create as many fields as you want. I'm going to sit back and say, yes, John is a veteran, and I'm going to come down here and click save. Now, here's one of the great things about Highlevel. I love many things about Highlevel because the tool is just so flexible and it works with absolutely any business. Let's just say that we created a custom field and now we want to create a smart list. A smart list is basically a saved, filtered view of your contact record so you can quickly select it anytime you're inside of your CRM system. Let me show you what I mean. So right now, I'm going to come over here to filters. And right now, if I wanted to, I could scroll down this whole list and notice all these different things I could filter off of. It has contact information, contact activity, opportunity information. But notice down here at the bottom, it has custom fields. That's right. That's insanely crazy. You can now filter based upon any custom field that you create in Highlevel. That is awesome. There's no other CRM systems allowing you to do that. So I'm going to select military veteran, and then I'm going to select this and choose yes. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to click apply. Notice that my list out here becomes filtered. Jane Smith goes away because Jane was not selected as yes as a military veteran because I didn't do that for her record, just for John. Now, let's just say in your particular business, you want to be able to quickly see all of the contact records in your database who are military veterans. So right now, we'd simply come down here and click on this button here at the bottom called Save a Smart List. So we're going to click on this. I just wanted to show you where it was. Click on this, and now we need to give this a name. So I'm going to call it veterans. And I'm going to click save. I'm going to clear this filter box out here. But notice now here at the top, notice here, we have the all option, which gives us all of our contacts. Now we can have a quick tab. This is the smart list feature. This is the great feature here. You can create as many smart lists as you want. Now you can simply click veterans and quickly filter all of the contact records that have veterans equal yes defined in their contact record. Totally awesome, right? I mean, this is really a game changer when it comes to adding all of your contacts to be able to sit back and organize all of your contacts and quickly find the slightest little attribute about a contact anywhere in your system. You can do this using custom fields. So This right here is just what I wanted to take a few minutes out, show you how you can utilize this, how you can incorporate this into your CRM and make your data organization regarding your CRM system much easier, and as well as being able to keep track of more information regarding your contacts. That's awesome. I hope you enjoyed my video. And again, if you haven't if you like the video, please give me a like on this thing. Leave me a comment if it was helpful. If you are confused and you want additional information, leave me a question. I always get back to everyone in my comments. And again, if you haven't subscribed, please click the button. I really appreciate it. And you have a great day. Bye-bye. Hey, I want to thank you again for visiting my channel and give you one more little thing here. If you are interested in Highlevel and getting some additional Highlevel training, please see the link in the description below. I do have a free course I'm offering that covers everything related to Highlevel and gives you all the information that you need to know. Thank you so much and have a great day.